make it tight.
JR, you gotta say, what is wrong with this picture? The game, Triple H, without the World Heavyweight Championship.
I admit it. Last night at WrestleMania, I lost the World Heavyweight Championship. This is the beginning of a new era. You are wrong if you think this is the start of the Batista era. You are wrong because Batista was great one night. One night. In this ring, WrestleMania 21, the biggest stage of all time, Batista was awesome. I will admit it, he was on, but it was one night. I am great every night. And that championship belt Batista is wearing around his waist, it gravitates towards greatness. And you know what that means? That means it will come back to me. It will find its way home because I own it. Batista was good once. I own the World Heavyweight Championship, and the rematch clause is rock solid. There is no way out. It will take place. The greatest rematch in the history of this industry. Batista, Triple H, two will take place, and when it is over, I will stand in this ring as the 11-time World Heavyweight Champion. And I can promise you this. I can promise you this. When I do, I will come back here and I will jam that championship belt down each and every one of your throats.
Man, powerful, powerful remarks from the irate yet confident chance, former champion who has exercised his rematch clause, but I question perhaps his line of thinking. I intend to believe that we are in the beginning of the Batista era, King.
Oh, I know that's what you love to think, but did you just not hear Triple H? Did you hear the game? Don't think that. Don't think that this is the Batista era beginning.
Now that was a big win for Shelton Benjamin. Yeah.
But not as big as the one I got last night in the Money in the Bank ladder match. So what do you say, let's make this official?
On the dotted line. So, I'm assuming I should go tell Batista that you're ready to exercise your world title match tonight?
Are you kidding me? I mean, not only is that contract money in the bank, but I am money in the bank. And I'll tell you when I'm damn good and ready to face Batista for the title.
Okay. Since you'll be telling me when you're ready to face Batista for the title, I think I should tell you who you'll be facing tonight. The Rabid Wolverine, Chris Benoit.
Batista, tonight is your big night. Your first live interview as World Heavyweight Champion. Enjoy it. Live the moment. You've worked very hard to get it, Dave. So enjoy it because you are on borrowed time. The rematch has been signed. It will be Batista, Triple H 2, and it will take place at Backlash. And Dave, I've told you already, you were awesome at WrestleMania. You, Batista, were on fire. You're right. He was awesome at WrestleMania. But I have watched the tape over and over, and you know me, Dave. I will find a weakness one way or another. And I have. It's in your eyes, Dave. It's in your eyes. You see, your eyes betrayed you. Your eyes showed fear every time I went for it. Your eyes told me the one thing I should have already known. Your eyes. Your eyes told me, Batista, the real story. Your eyes told me what I should have already known. It is the one thing that made me a 10-time World Heavyweight Champion. And it is the one thing that will make me an 11-time World Champion. It is the one thing you fear, Dave. It is the pedigree. You fear it. You know it, and now I know it. Because the pedigree is the one move that when I hit it, this whole thing will be done. This lie that you are living, Batista, will be over because the pedigree is the truth. And the truth is, Batista, you made the biggest mistake of your life when you decided to screw with me. So So now Batista.
Stand back. There's a hurricane coming through.
Oh, no. Okay. What is he doing? What the hell is this, JR?
I have no idea.
I'm certain that the game was not finished talking.
I would agree.
Triple H. You claim to be the best, the most celebrated superstar in the history of society. But holy ass kickings. For when last we saw you in action, you were wearing a mask. No, not a hurricane mask, a bloody Crimson mask, as you got demolished by Batista. What's up with that?
Oh my gosh.
Listen up, Green Tomato. I do not have the time nor the patience
Green
for this.
Green Tomato? Oh, you got time. For when last you went toe-to-toe with the superhero, you left me laying. And the following week did the same to Rosie. And that's something my hurt conscience just can't seem to forget. So in the words of my good friend, The Thing, it's clobbering time.
Come on. You want me? Come on.
What is clobbering time? Has he taken leave of his her senses?
I'm impressed with the courage of... Wait a minute.
Wait a minute.
The hurricane looks to be bringing some backup. Here's a... If Triple H is not like this, it's right into the face of the game. And the game
is... Oh, look at this. Look at this.
A resourceful ring general.
Beautiful.
The game using the ropes for, as a tag partner. And the Hurricane straddling that top turnbuckle. And that changes the shade of green. It's the complexion of this match wholeheartedly.
Yeah, Hurricane went green, all right.
Triple H has a blatant choke. That's what he's doing. And the referee, Triple H got to be careful. He doesn't get disqualified here.
Triple H has to pull out all the stops right here. I mean, he's too
Look at this. Oh, Rosie's hung on the ropes. Rosie's hung on the ropes.
Triple H just tightened him up.
Rosie's helpless in those ropes.
Oh, boy, here it comes.
Look out, pedigree time.
I hope Batista's watching this. You said Batista's watching somewhere. Coming up.
A vicious pedigree, rimming Hurricane's face into the canvas.
Yeah, and if that happened to Batista, it'll be all over. Backlash will have 11 time world heavyweight champion. It's all about the pedigree, JR.
I can't disagree that the game's pedigree is the difference maker. There's no doubt about that.
Look at Rosie. He'll hang up like a side of beef.
Rosie trying to get out of that predicament there. And Rosie trying to assist this match.
The game will help me.
Come on.
Oh, goodness.
Come on now. The match is over. Rosie's helpless.
Well,
Rosie's helpless here.
I'm going to tell you, I knew the Triple H was going to foul move. Look at nobody's safe.
Triple H assaulting a helpless man here. Rosie tied upside down. And the game, that nasty, that dominating mean streak.
I wouldn't want to be Batista. Even if he is the world champion right now.
Look at the carnage here at the hands of the game.
Oh, wait.
Batista! You see this? 1 second. 1 second is all it takes. One pedigree. And that is you. You don't believe me? I vow to you, by the end of the night, this will be Batista. I will pedigree his ass in this ring. It doesn't matter to me how big he is.
Did he say tonight?
He sure as hell did. The game said he's going to pedigree the world's champion right here tonight.
Oh, my God. He'll pedigree. He'll pedigree the referee.
You've done enough to Rosie's helpless. Oh, come on, man. No.
Batista,
you
just just got a glimpse into your future, and he said tonight, didn't he?
Triple H said that he was going to do the same thing to Batista tonight. The game has pedigreed a 400-pound man into oblivion.
1 second, JR. One pedigree. That's all it takes.
Triple H bowed. He will do the same thing to the world's champion live here tonight. Well, ladies and gentlemen, in just a few moments, we will have the privilege of talking for the first time to the new World's Heavyweight Champion King, Batista, live right here.
I'm not too pleased
with Edge's conduct, quite frankly.
Well, we can't worry about what pleases you, JR.
I know that. It's all about me.
Edge is what it's all about with Edge is this briefcase right here. Inside this briefcase is that World Championship contract for Mr. Money in the Bank.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, in just a few moments, we will have the privilege of talking for the first time to the new World's Heavyweight Champion King, Batista, live right here on Raw.
Oh, yeah. Batista, he's smiling, he's looking tough, but will he be pedigreed before he leaves this arena here tonight? It's been promised to Batista by none other than Triple H.
Batista, champion next. Ladies and gentlemen, many said that it couldn't be done, but at WrestleMania 21, in the middle of this very ring, we crowned a new World's Heavyweight Champion. I'd like to bring him out now. Please welcome the animal known as Batista!
We're here to talk, but it looks like you're dressed to compete.
I'll tell you what, JR. I heard Triple H. I heard him calling me out saying he was going to give me the pedigree. I figured I'd make it easy on him. Here I am in my gear, ready to go.
Well, speaking of Triple H, he does have a rematch with you coming up at Backlash. Edge won the Money in the Bank ladder match at WrestleMania. He's got an opportunity he can invoke at any time. Are you concerned, Dave, about all these guys gunning for you?
Concerned? No, I'm not concerned. I knew when I became World Heavyweight Champion, I'd be a hunted man. That's just the law of the jungle. But I refuse, refuse to be anyone's victim. I'm the man. I'm the predator. I'm the world heavyweight champion, and I'm the top of the food chain.
Indeed he is.
So if anyone, and I mean anyone, has any bright ideas on taking what I've worked so hard to get, just like Triple H at WrestleMania, and just like Randy Orton last week, I will chew them up, spit them out, and I'll enjoy doing it. This is my jungle. And Triple H, if you're looking in my eyes and seeing fear, I think you're just looking at your own reflection in the mirror. And once again, you're underestimating me. And once again, that will be your downfall. I don't plan on being 10-time world champion, but I do plan on being the world champion for as long as I want. Man. History. I'm gonna shut your big mouth once and for all. What? Next week, you and I are gonna go one on one.
Well, next week?
Sounds good, huh? That's right. Next week, it's gonna be the game against JR.
Against JR? What? Did Triple H just say next week is gonna be him versus JR? This is not good.
It's all about the game.
It's not good at all.
All about your
next week, Madison Square Garden, Triple H against JR. And I have to get myself a new broadcast partner after next week's broadcast. I can't believe this.
No way you can
JR.
No way.
Big night tonight.
Huge night tonight. First, I got my state of the pizza dress, then the main event against Batista.
And remember, man, no matter what situation brings itself out there, just stick to the plan.
Oh, you got it.
Stick to the plan, right? Yeah.
Girls! Don't know what you're talking about. Don't really care. Because right now, all we're talking and thinking about is Triple H, okay? He's mad. So you have one job tonight. You as an individual or you collectively are going to go out, take Batista, beat him within an inch of his life. Then Triple H will walk in. He'll clamp the pedigree at him. Boom! Like that.
Before you give yourself a heart attack.
Oh, my God.
All right? Yeah. I'm going to tell you what Triple H is going to do tonight, okay? I'm going to tell you what Triple H is going to do.
You tell me?
Yeah, I'm going to tell you. Exactly nothing. That's what Triple H is going to do tonight. Tonight is my night. Tonight is Captain Charisma's night. To prove that he deserves to be in the ring. It's not my fault that Triple H can't hit a pedigree on Batista, but if you want to tell Triple H something, don't look at me like that in my dressing room. You want to tell Triple H something? You tell him if he wants some competition? Maybe he should try getting himself drafted to SmackDown next month.
Oh, really?
Yeah, yeah, really. Maybe he can beat Michael Cole.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
How about if you beat me right now?
You want to do it?
I'll jump in.
You want to do it right now?
Yeah,
huh?
Yeah.
Escort Mr. Flair out of my dressing room. Right now. I got things to do.
He became the new world heavyweight champion with his shocking defeat of the Cerebral Assassin at WrestleMania. Relive Batista's incredible victory in the May issue of Raw magazine. Available tomorrow.
Let me know if anybody comes down that hall, all right?
Hey,
Nate, let's go inside and talk, huh?
How about talking here?
Here?
Yeah. What do you got there?
Oh, you forgot your jacket in my locker room. I just want to bring it back to you, huh?
Not a wrinkle.
No, that's nice, good, nice, huh?
Thanks, yeah, thanks.
Yeah, oh, I wanted to apologize, but...
Hey, where's Tom Cole?
Tom Cole, he's around.
Okay, gotcha. Good one, huh?
That's good. About Tom Cole, all right? Just, I want to apologize about the things that he said earlier. I mean, he just... Sometimes you can't shut the guy up. He spouts off in the mouth, man. I mean... He had me all worked up, but that idea you were talking about, that was good stuff.
You like
I think
it?
We should talk more about it. I think we should.
That's good.
Yeah?
Hold on. Okay.
Right? Can I come in?
It's not.
All right, Nature, hurry up, all right? I mean, it's not doing anybody any good to have me out here. I mean, probably get a lot more accomplished if I was in there talking about stuff. Hey, Trips, what's going on, man? What you doing? Looking good?
Michael Cole, huh?
That was a joke, man. I was just...
You want to do some business?
Business is good.
Business. Let's go inside and talk about it, then.
All right, yeah. Sounds good. We're just talking here, huh?
Neckbreaker attempt, and a hard shot right to the spine. There's the neckbreaker by Christian. Christian going for the cover. He's got the left hook, the count, finally, and a near fall.
Don't quite have him, but certainly softening up the champ here.
There's a choke hold. Looked like a choke to me.
Well, Coach does need to get in a little closer to the action where he can see exactly what's going down.
Do you think?
Those chokes are hard to detect.
Oh, so they sure are. And now the problem solver for the night, Triple H, the coaching a little bit of for Christian.
Give me I'll some. Be honest with you. Actually, Triple H has caused a few problems tonight for Batista.
Batista standing up, and that's bad for Christian.
Oh, look out here. Oh, my gosh.
The power of the world's champion, sending Christian sailing. Batista with a right hand and another right, knocking down Christian.
This is a big trouble for Captain Charisma now.
Christian being handled like a rag doll.
I tell you, these fans here in the United Kingdom, they're a bit different. They've allowed Well, there's a lot of peach here.
Batista, he measures Christian in this one fall match and buries that huge shoulder right into the abdomen. The momentum has completely changed back into the corner of the world's champion.
Yes, it has.
Batista surrounded in very unfriendly territory. And I'm not talking about the UK. Flair now up on the apron, the timekeeper. There's a problem solver for the night.
Watch,
look out behind you.
Get back, Batista.
Oh, look out here. Christian going for the unprettier.
He hits this. Uh-oh.
Oh, look at the. Oh, my God, the power.
Christian about to be taken for a ride.
It's the power. The electric chair. Batista with the electric chair. That should do it right there. Ligament.
Oh, look at him!
What a clothesline!
His head torn off!
Hope got what he deserved! Tore a lip! And all the Triple H goes down! And Blair goes down! And Christian! And Five Buster time!
Look out!
Batista! Over the top goes it! The number one contender for the world title!
Look at Batista!
Batista's fighting off all these odds! Captain Charisma in his main event opportunity.
Oh, Batista bomb!
What impact! It's selling a car wreck. The cover, and look at Batista. Kenny, Christian down from Coach's left arm. That's what we're hitting on, by God.
Batista! Oh, look at him.
Oh, Triple H not through on Batista yet. Triple H back in the ring. Triple H loves right hand. Triple H trying to beat Batista down to win the champion before this Sunday. And Batista fighting back. Flair with a chair. And down goes the Nature Boy.
Can anything stop Batista? It looks like no.
Another hard shot by the world's champion. Triple H just thrown out.
No. Batista's got a chair.
Oh, my God.
Triple H.
Batista with a steel chair.
You got a problem. You better stop.
Oh, downstairs. Oh, no.
Pedigree.
Triple H got the pedigree on Batista. Triple H just hit the pedigree on the world's heavyweight champion.
Batista dives near the pedigree. He does. And there's five.
Batista got thrilled. Face first with the pedigree. The difference maker. The pedigree is the truth.
I told you, JR. I told you. The pedigree.
Watching you last night. Did a really good job.
Excuse me. Christy, would you please just give us a few moments?
Sure.
Thank you.
Don't go anywhere.
Okay.
Well, whatever. Batista, I'm here to congratulate you. What a phenomenal title defense you had last night against Triple H. It was an amazing, amazing match. Congratulations.
Thank you.
And I thought tonight would be a perfect night. A perfect night to announce an 8-man tournament to name the new number one contender for the World Heavyweight title. And I thought I'd call the tournament the Gold Rush Tournament. You like that?
Yeah.
Well, you like this even better. You see, because these eight men, they're going to know that they're in the tournament. But what they don't know is who their opponent is going to be until the ring announcer announces their name. It'll be a complete surprise. And better yet, the very first match tonight on Raw is going to begin the tournament. Not bad, huh?
Yeah.
And you know what else? Earlier today, I was thinking about it. I thought, you know, I'm going to find Batista because he works so hard. I know how hard you train to face Triple H. I'm going to give Batista the night off. What do you think, Batista? Take some time, relax a little.
Sounds good, but not tonight. I'm going to hang around. But, you know, I'm thinking I'm on a roll. Think maybe I'd like a match tonight. But I was trying to come up with an opponent. You know, maybe someone brave, someone powerful, someone brave enough to take on Vince McMahon in the Monday Night Wars. Yeah, you know, I was thinking since Triple H got to wrestle JR, maybe I'd like to have a match with you. Maybe we can go ahead and start that match right now!
No, 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 no!
Man, relax, lighten up. You need the night off.
Bischoff selected.
Well, let's see the look on his face.
And his opponent.
Who?
Oh, no! Oh, my God! Oh, no!
Weighing in at 320 pounds, King!
Just King! Christian's got to face King in the...
No, wait, look. I think Captain Charisma has left the building, and I don't blame him.
King, who was pushed to the limit last night at Backlash by Viscera, has been selected here as Captain Charisma's opponent in this first ever Gold Rush tournament to determine a new number one contender. Kane was up on the top turnbuckle. Referee didn't, wait a minute, come to the unprettier.
Oh yes, we got,
And Kane catches Christian in midair. Christian again, able to escape a thumb to the eye.
How resourceful is Captain Charisma? And now the problem solver's back up here again.
Oh, back
look out!
Kane turned the table on Christian.
Oh, no!
that match?
Better yet, were you rapping last night at Backlash? Were you talking about Ric Flair and Triple H?
I can't remember.
You just lost. I spent all day thinking about this. I'm gonna rap for you. You lost the match, kid, so take it from an H. The winner of this tournament will be Triple H. Woo! Woo!
I hate that guy.
Just as we came on the air, an eight-man single elimination tournament. Kane is already qualified. It's to determine a new number one contender. There'll be three other matches here tonight, Kane, but
you and I don't even have a clue who's going to be the contenders.
And neither do the contenders.
Oh,
what a night.
This is going to be great.
Three more main events live tonight from Boston. Athleticism by the former University of Minnesota.
No, Sean, he didn't go.
Shelton landing on his feet. Oh my God in heaven! The sweet tin music! It is academic!
He had to kick his head off!
Here's your winner, the Heartbreak Kid, Shawn Michaels!
Shelton Benjamin might never wake up!
I'm standing by now with the man who we've just learned will be in the next Gold Rush tournament match, Edge. And Edge, my question is, why are you in this tournament when you've already got a guaranteed title match in the bank?
Todd, Big T, let's not gloss over the fact that last night I beat Chris Benoit in a last man standing match. Yeah, the same Chris Benoit who you and everyone else says is the toughest man in the WWE, the rabid Wolverine. Well, I left him in an unconscious heap. And I guess that makes Mr. Money in the Bank the toughest man in the WWE. So you ask me the question, why? Why would I want two title matches? My answer is that no one, not even Batista, can withstand two title matches against me.
Well, I guess then the only thing that could stop you would be if you were drafted to go over to SmackDown later this month, then your guaranteed title match would be useless.
What are you trying to say, Chump Stain?
You have a guaranteed world title shot, which is here on Raw. On SmackDown, they have the WWE Championship, which
all that matters is that I will be champion. Bank on it. This interview's over.
You can bank on that, JR. Good point, though.
Look, everybody's screaming aloud when you know this.
You two looking at?
Absolutely nothing.
Could be looking at the number one contender. We know Edge is in the tournament.
The following is the third Gold Rush tournament match scheduled for one fall.
You think you know me?
Well, we knew that this man, Edge, was going to be in the tournament. We don't know his opponent.
Toronto, Canada, weighing in at 250 pounds, Edge!
Edge last night used that briefcase very handily in the last man standing match with Chris Benoit.
With a briefcase? He covered Chris Benoit with a brick, JR!
He's not a brick, Mason. He's a wrestler. And last night, Edge took a brick right out of that briefcase. He hit Chris Benoit in the back of the head with it, and Benoit then could not rise before the pin count, and Benoit lost the last man standing match to Edge.
That's right. Edge had two chances now. You know, last night he was a bricklayer. He used a brick and he laid out Benoit. It was a thing of beauty.
Edge has already got a guaranteed world title match at his possession in that briefcase. From WrestleMania 21, Money in the Bank ladder match.
And his opponent.
Triple H, who is it?
I don't know. Who's it going to be?
Uh-oh.
Well, there's your answer.
Uh-oh.
There is your answer. A hungry, a motivated.
Jericho!
hides his eyes. He's a madman.
Here he comes. Oh, the spear. That's it. The spear by Edge.
Yes.
And the three count. Edge advances. Jericho is eliminated.
Your winner, Edge.
And ladies and gentlemen, the tournament continues. The Gold Rush Tournament. Triple H is next. But who will he face? Who will the game meet next, live on Monday Night Raw?
The following is the final first round match in the Gold Rush Tournament, and it is scheduled for one fall.
This emotional spike, and then he pedigreed a defenseless official. You condone those actions?
How would you feel if you got screwed out of the World Heavyweight Championship? Think that this man loved more than life itself.
Well, Batista's a better man at WrestleMania. Batista's a better man at Backlash. And ladies and gentlemen, next week, this tournament continues in Wilkes-Barre, Pennsylvania, next Monday night. We look forward to our raucous crowd live and crazy next Monday night in Wilkes-Barre.
Yep. Who's going to be Triple H's victor? I'm telling you, in a rare mood that he's in, I don't care who it is.
Triple H coming off the loss 24 hours ago.
Yeah, Triple H, check the record books. He's never lost twice, not two in a row.
And his opponent.
Who? Who?
Oh, no. The game didn't like that.
And
you'll see why. Here it is. Chris Benoit, because it's just as much win for Benoit as it is for Triple H. This is a single elimination tournament. Your leaders are gone. And Flair, the insurance policy.
Whoa! Oh, Flair, you can't do that!
Flair brought into the ring by Benoit.
You can't do that to Flair! Let
referee
do something!
Benoit lighting up Flair. Referee's trying to restrain Benoit. Another shot to the back of the head. Triple H got that shot to the back of Benoit's head.
Well, this is Flair getting a little revenge for what Benoit did to him.
Two on one.
Yeah.
What kind of man is Triple H to condone this and now that? is Benoit. Who's going to win the final slot in the Gold Rush Tournament? Oh, no! Batista for the game! No! Get to the ropes! But Triple H tap! Looking into the eyes of Batista! The game is in all he can not to tap!
We gotta hold on! Hang on! Survive!
Contender, but Triple H is not. The game is lost. Two huge matches in a row in 24 hours.
Unbelievable!
Batista, the better man, last night at Backlash, and tonight Batista again imposing his will. The world's heavyweight champion has made a difference tonight. What a tournament! I'll see you next week, everybody!
The tournament, a new number one contender, continues tonight in the semifinals.
Oh, that's right, the Rabid Wolverine! Chris Benoit is going to go head-to-head with the Big Red Machine, Kane!
And in the second and final semifinal match live tonight, it will be the incomparable Shawn Michaels against Mr. Money in the Bank Edge, HBK versus Edge. Two semifinal matches live tonight.
Come on.
No, hey, forget
no,
it.
I'm here.
Let me talk to you.
I am out of here. No.
No, you are the franchise.
We're gone. Let's
you
go.
Are the franchise here.
No.
Don't worry Rick. About Batista. It means nothing. Rick, you're not going. Please. You're the I'm franchise. Why would you leave?
Rick, get in the car. Rick, get in the car.
I can't do that, man. I got to stay here and get this resolved. You're the franchise, brother. You make this company run. I'm going to walk in there, and I'm going to get Bischoff in the corner.
Yourself.
I'm going to make this right. Where are you going? What are you doing? This is the second message. I still have not got things resolved with Bischoff, but you need to know everything you said tonight is the truth. You should be the World Heavyweight Champion. You are the man. You are the franchise. Raw will never be the same without you. I will work things out. I promise. I'll call you later. What do you want?
Why so hostile? Nate, I was just standing over there. I mean, you look upset. You look down. You look a little worried. I mean, you were the first one there to console me last week after my loss in the Gold Rush Tournament. I mean, I just wanted to return the favor. Make sure you're okay. So what is it? What's got you down? Triple H leaving? I mean, did he take his ball and go home? I mean, I know what's got you upset. I mean, who's going to spit water all over themselves tonight? Nate, if you're looking for somebody to suck up to 24/7, you can always suck up to me.
I don't like you.
You don't.
I don't like you, and you picked the wrong day to jump on Nature Boy Ric Flair.
Is that right?
Yeah, 16 times the world champion. You double zeros, Captain Courageous or Charisma, whatever your name is. You picked the wrong day. So guess what? Why don't you and I go out there tonight and do our thing? Me, Ric Flair, the Nature Boy, and you, Captain. You tell me, Captain. You tell. You call the shot. You and me tonight, Raw.
Yeah. Okay. You want it?
Yeah. Yeah, I want it bad. Yeah.
You got it.
Woo! Yeah. I think it's like, yeah. Woo! Woo!
That's it. Yeah, that's how it goes.
Live. You like physicality? You're going to love this next.
Could do some more.
Another shot to the back of the head. Benoit still on his heart, still beating, so you know he'll fight you. But is there enough left? Is there enough left? A touch slam. A hard touch slam. A thunderous touch slam. And a victory by Kane.
Here is your winner, Kane.
As much pain as Lita's obviously in, that still brings a smile to her face.
Well, Kane has advanced to the finals of the Gold Rush Tournament to determine the new number one contender for Batista's World Heavyweight title. Also next week, the finals of the Gold Rush Tournament. Who'll be the number one contender? It'll be Kane facing either Edge or Shawn Michaels. We're about to find out who. Who's going to get it done? Edge or the Showstopper? Take so many of those. Got the referees, and now the Impaler DDT. The DDT, big time version, supersized by Edge, drilling Michaels into the canvas with that DDT. But much to Edge's chagrin, if he ever gets it, the referee is out.
You don't think Shawn Michaels hit the referee intentionally, do you?
Hell no, I don't. Absolutely not. Certainly gives Edge the opportunity to clear his head and to get that one more burst of adrenaline, that explosion.
Edge is biding his time, waiting for Shawn Michaels to get to his feet, and he's going to cut him in half. Here he goes.
HBK to stop the shoulder edge. There's a cover. That ref, come on, ref. There's a cover. Edge is not moving.
No, ref.
Michaels has got to revive the referee. He's got to revive the referee.
You, Edge is knocked out. You can just get.
Edge is trying to. He's shuffling. He's moving, but the referee, Mike Keown, is down.
Shawn Michaels is still hurting too. The side of his head is.
Michaels is waiting. Where's Edge going?
Michaels is. Oh, wait. Come on. Edge has got that briefcase. No, damn it. Wait a minute. No.
Oh, look out. He missed him.
Michaels dodged a bullet right there. A big bullet. Oh, he dodged another one.
Oh, look at this.
That was land on his feet from the back body drop.
Sunset Flip.
Sunset Flip.
No! Oh,
no! Oh, no! Buddy, no! And the briefcase was given. Michaels has been knocked his ass out. No!
Did you hear the impact? Look.
I don't know. Get in this way.
Okay, but I don't think you understand my position.
Boss, I got that. Oh, sorry, there you are. I need to talk to you right now.
Coach, I'm in a meeting.
No, you don't understand. Chris Benoit and Jerry are getting ready.
Coach.
What?
I said I'm in a meeting.
Okay.
I'm sorry. You were saying?
I was saying Triple H is a 10-time World Heavyweight Champion. The greatest wrestler alive today, the franchise player on Raw, but he's got a huge ego. It goes with the territory. You've got to call him. He's not gonna call you.
Whoa. Rick, I've said this before and I'm gonna say it again. I'm the general manager of Raw. I am not going to call Triple H. If he wants to come back to Raw, he can call me.
Really?
Just handle it.
Handle it?
Handle it.
Handle Triple H? I'll handle it all right.
Dave Batista, I need to talk to you. Everything that's wrong in my life right now is because of you. Everything that's wrong in sports entertainment right now is because of you. Last week, Triple H got in a limousine, drove off the property. He quit Raw because of you. The guy that brought you to Raw, the guy that made you part of Evolution, the guy that trained you, taught you how to dress, taught you how to wrestle, worked with you to make you mentally tough enough to be a champion one day, that guy's gone. That hurts the product.
Rick, he's my best friend. It hurts me.
Rick, you're wrong, man. This has nothing to do with me. And it's not my fault. And it's not your fault. It's Triple H's fault. And I don't owe him anything. Nothing. I didn't start with him. I didn't start with Evolution. If I owe anybody, it's you. I started with you. Rick? I've said a million times, man, I have nothing but respect for you, but you're wrong. This is not my fault. I got a match, man.
Hey, Rick. Check it out.
I've been working on this. It's not very good, but you'll like it. You'll appreciate it. It's my tribute to Ric Flair.
Woo!
That's rotten, right? Kids like this.
Woo!
Go ahead, Nature Boy. Give him hell out there, man. You're the man.
Of Christian, and now the Nature Boy, right back in control. Oh, here he goes. Oh, hey, oh! Straight right hand by Tom Cole on the outside. Referee didn't see it. Flair looked to be going for the figure four leg lock. And there's a roll up by Christian. And Christian's got a handful of ropes there. Referee good officiating, caught it. Oh, hey, and Flair now counters. The
wait, 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 what about the tights?
I didn't see the tights.
You didn't see the tights?
I see Flair winning.
He had so much tights, you can see the moon from Christian.
The Nature Boy, Ric Flair.
The master with a PhD just schooled Christian on the art of how you counter and win a match by any means necessary.
Big problem, Tomko.
Uh-oh, look at Flair.
Christian now from behind. Christian and Tomko double teaming Flair. Christian, after losing to Flair by hook or crook, I'll give him that, now double teaming the Nature Boy. Well, with straight right hands, Flair defenseless here.
That loss was a big problem for Captain Charisma, but it's being solved now.
This crowd very upset at what they're seeing here, and quite obviously Tomko and Christian manhandling the Nature Boy, Ric Flair.
Wait a minute.
You gotta be kidding me.
Oh, look out, guys.
The world's heavyweight champion, Batista. Batista coming to Flair's aid and rocking Big Tomko.
Oh, Captain Charisma, this is not a wise move.
Captain Charisma, the right hand. And Christian,
oh,
what a clothesline.
Well, took his head off.
Oh, what a clothesline. Spinebuster.
I told you, you should have ran when you had the chance. Out to your peeps.
Oh, look out, Christian.
Oh, no. This is bad.
Batista bomb, drilling Christian. This Batista, the animal, the world's heavyweight champion.
No.
Oh, my God. Batista with ease. Batista bombing a 300 pounder. I'll tell you what, Batista is damn sure king, a man of his word. He said he respected Ric Flair.
I guess this proves it.
epitome of King of Ridge. We'll meet Batista for the world title next week. But they're going to do each other. They'll do it next.
Oh, he's got another spear, JR.
And it's looking to uncoil on the monster.
He's got him. He doesn't.
Kane sidestep. Again, reverse elbow. Catching Kane in the mouth.
Oh, he's beginning to catch it.
Sidewalk slam. And the monster is smiling because he knows he's back in control.
He just got Gold Rush fever again.
Lita smiling. Her husband back in control.
There's going to be a big celebration in their room tonight. Oh, look out.
Can't throw. Whoa. And Shaquin running to the referee. And Shaquin.
Spear.
A spear by Edge. Edge shall Kane run into referee Kyoto.
But now there's no referee. Come on, cover him. Turn over, ref.
Oh, Kane set up.
Uh-oh.
My God, Kane set up.
Oh, no.
Oh, Edge got that damn briefcase. Edge got that briefcase. That's how he's been winning these matches. Kane. No briefcase tonight. You can take the day off. Lita's got the briefcase for safekeeping. Man, what a shot to the face by Kane.
Edge has used that briefcase in every match he's won, and now he's briefcaseless.
Wait a minute.
Lita dropped the briefcase.
Did this man's wife? Kane trying to get to the top. He's oh, my God, Kane. And wait a minute.
What in the hell is going on here?
Lita trying to revive the referee. Kane head first into that metal briefcase.
That Lita threw to him. Through the edge.
Edge got the left hook. Kane's not moving. There's a counter. You can't
believe this.
Wait a minute. This is... making me ill.
Well, they were married for better or for worse, and Lita couldn't have done better, but Kane couldn't have done worse. Look at this. Can you believe this,
Jim? Oh, my God, what we witnessed here tonight. I mean, come on. Think about it. Has Edge destroyed this relationship? Is that his goal? Is that the kind of man that he is? I know one thing. The Dirty Rotten Bastard's going to wrestle for the world title next Monday night in Green Bay.
Can't call him a dirty rock.
The hell I can't. I'm not gonna hurt. I'm not gonna call her what I'm thinking.
She screwed Kane.
Kane trying to set up. His head driven in it. Yeah, think about it.
I don't think he can believe what he's seen.
Now what?
Don't do this. Now we keep watching. Oh, my God.
Jesus Christ. My God, what the? That's a man's wife. That's a man's wife. What the hell are you people thinking here? What the hell are you thinking? You'll pay for that someday. You'll pay for that someday. What are you thinking? You damn heart.
Boy. I've wanted to say this all day long. I just didn't know how to do it. And you know me pretty well. You've been in H for 30 plus years. Sometimes it's hard to say things that are very heartfelt. But I want to say thanks for last week. I think you really showed the people what kind of man you really are. And this is where I want to go with it. means that much. Good luck with that, Jeanette. A guy like you, easy, easy money. Easy money.
You think you know me?
And we are back live here, ladies and gentlemen, on Monday Night Raw. Jim Ross and Jerry the King are live from Green Bay, Wisconsin. It's title town, and the richest title in this business about to be decided: the World Heavyweight Championship. Well, you got to give credit to Edge, JR. I don't care what you think about Edge and Lita's relationship. You got to give credit to Mr. Money in the Bank after all he's been through to be where he is now.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall, and it is for the World Heavyweight Championship. Introducing the challenger from Toronto, Canada, weighing in at 250 pounds, Edge.
Well, Edge can certainly be called a lot of things. Mr. Money in the Bank could be one. A relationship breaker. A relationship record could be another one. But tonight it could be the best of all.
Yeah.
The heavyweight champion of the world.
He likes to be called that.
And that's what it's all about in this business. To be on top of the mountain. Looking down upon all as the heavyweight champion of the world.
A lot of kissing on Raw. I like that.
We'll get no ideas.
Big ovation!
And from Washington, D.C., weighing in at 318 pounds, he is the World Heavyweight Champion, Batista!
6 feet six, 317 pounds!
Is that Edge won the Gold Rush tournament. He beat some impressive individuals.
Right. And you need to get over this thing with him and Lita, transgression. Breakups happen every day, JR.
Life That's what it's on. About right there, ladies and gentlemen. The World's Heavyweight Championship. It's not about relationships and none of that other BS. It's about being the heavyweight Edge fighting back to his credit. But he's staggered by the world's champion, Batista. So big, so powerful, so strong and intense. Oh, it's Henry Edge.
You cannot match what Batista.
Clothesline. What impact?
Oh no, Batista's gaining momentum here.
That's the clothesline could connect.
Oh, no! Oh my God!
Now the referee's head may be cracked open. Edge and the referee collided, and Batista. The modified power slam on Edge. Oh, the referee's down. This is
oh no, this is
unsettling as hell. And
Batista. Yeah. Oh, powerful shot. What a shot by Tom. Oh,
did you see that?
Into this double team. Like a pack of wild dogs attacking the world's champion with a referee down and a title on the line.
This is money in the bank. You can't help but enjoy this, Dave.
This is absolutely hideous.
This is a deal coming to fruition. This is a...
What the hell is...
What is Flair doing?
It's Nature Boy Rick Flair.
What the hell?
Batista's Eddie!
Look out!
The Nature Boy is styling and profiling! And we're all
here!
Where is my spear? I mean, a big time spear! And now look at Tonto and Christian beating the hell out of Ric Flair, who came to save Batista! Trying to get there.
It just
oh,
done
no,
it.
No, no, no.
Yes.
No.
Yes, he's
no,
done
no,
it.
No, no.
Kill.
Let's go. Kill.
Come on.
Batista kicked out, by God. And I'm not a leader.
Briefcase.
No. This is not right. This is not right. This is how Edge won the tournament to start with. And the referee is still at him.
This is why it's called Money in the Bank. And Edge is about to cash it in.
Oh, no.
Come on, off the boat.
My God, Batista. He aborted that metal briefcase. But what a slam to Edge. Raw, animalistic power.
Oh, I don't like the looks of this.
Thumbs up, thumbs down. And we know what that means.
Edge. Edge.
Batista ball. Batista ball. The leg is up. Finally, the count.
No.
At least for a moment, off of the world's tip.
I can't believe it. I can't believe it. I'm stunned.
Batista has overcome every obstacle and all the odds. The world's champion has walked through hell, fired. I'll tell you why he has done it. Tell you what, folks, you can damn sure thank Ric Flair, because Flair had a major part in Batista surviving.
Batista's ordeal. Batista certainly thanking the Nature Boy right here.
The legendary Ric Flair and Batista did the right thing.
Batista, my hands are tied. Triple H has an interview tonight with JR, and Triple H requested to do that interview from the studios in Stamford, Connecticut. Triple H is not even here tonight.
Yeah, that figures. All right. You tell Triple H, Hell in the Cell, I accept. But I want him here next week, and I want him to put it in writing. In writing.
Oh, make no mistake about it, Triple H will be here next week. And that contract will be signed in writing. You have my word. At Hell in a Cell, it's going to be Triple H versus the World Heavyweight
it
Champion.
But
what's going on here? What's Triple H done to deserve a title match? Triple H lost at WrestleMania, and Triple H lost at Backlash. But Eric, I am undefeated, which means I've never lost a match. So you know what this is? This is an example of the prejudiced and the racist administration.
It's about time someone shut you up. I'll tell you what, Bischoff. Since Hunter's not here, I'm gonna take out my frustration on Hassan. Make the match.
Batista, I love the sounds of that. Tonight, in that very ring, It's going to be Muhammad Hassan against a world heavyweight champion, Batista. And it's going to happen tonight.
I guess Shomo fake me kuni muzuna Muhammad Hassan begini ye chizi dige ogo famini famini.
Oh! Who do you think you are, Batista? Huh? I'll see you tonight. Huh?
Man, Batista, step right up!
Oh, he's got to shut Muhammad up tonight.
I'm not got there
great
yet.
Great movie, great movie.
But I'm going to.
This guy should be in Hollywood. The Walk would do him good.
Batista, not finishing Muhammad Hassan! Batista, like a runaway train here!
next week.
Oh.
Contract signing.
Well,
Triple H may have second thoughts when he looks at this. You know he's got to be watching this right now. You know the game's eyes are glued on this. The blood flowing from the head of Daivari and Batista. He can be barbaric and sadistic. Batista may be Hell in a Cell worthy. There's no doubt about it. Somebody's going to hell, but only one will return.
Most barbaric, sadistic, twisted, violent match in this industry. Hell in a Cell. And I have made a career of ending them in that cell. You are gonna go face to face with the devil himself. Dave, people are gonna tell you to fear the cell. Don't fear the cell, Dave. Fear me. Dave, you and I are going to hell. But only one of us is coming back. And I am coming back.
I believe. That made a believer out of me.
Goosebumps. Goosebumps. Can you feel it? Because I can. It's coming home, Jack. It's coming home. Batista, you were lucky. One time, lightning struck a second time, and it was unbelievable. But it will not happen a third time.
Something to say about that. The heavyweight champion of the world with a thunderous ovation here in St. Louis. Batista walking with a purpose, King. And this could be an explosion to...
I don't think Bischoff's got enough security in the ring.
This is a very combustible situation. When you think back 2 weeks ago from Triple H's sledgehammer attack on the world's champion. Who will survive Hell in a Cell and vengeance?
I don't know. From the looks of Batista's face, I don't think that film did anything to intimidate the world heavyweight champion. Do you?
You're done talking. You know, I don't know what it's like to be in Hell in a Cell. I don't know what to expect. At this point, I don't really care. I know we're both gonna get hurt. I know we're both gonna bleed. I know we're both gonna go till we can't go anymore. We're going to hell, Hunter. You hear me? We're going to hell. I'm ready to pay for my sins. How about you? You ready to pay? Hunter, I don't fear the cell, and I don't fear you.
Gentlemen, it is time to make this official. Please.
Well, Batista has beaten Triple H twice.
Now, Triple H, you've had an opportunity to review the contract. As the challenger, I ask that you please sign first. As a defending champion, I ask that you sign the contract. It is official. At Vengeance, it will be Triple H versus Batista. Hell in the Cell for the world title. You just signed your own death warrant.
Good. Because you're going to have to kill me to take this.
Really? You're going to have to kill me to stop me. You know something, Dave? You and I, we've been through a lot, huh? I know one thing, no matter what happens at Hell in a Cell, when Vengeance is done, this thing between you and me, it's gonna be over. For good.
Said we were going to hell, and I was going to meet the devil. And Vengeance, I'm going to kick the devil's ass.
Bischoff, get that security moving around. This could implode right here. If I know Triple H, he'd like to get this thing started right now. He doesn't want to wait till Vengeance. Get him. Oh, what a... Triple H is backing off, King.
No, he's not.
But he can't back off from that Hell in a Cell, I'll tell you that.
You really think he's got a major league player coming across? I mean, you're Triple H, the greatest wrestler alive today. Who could he bring across that could possibly?
You know, Rick, just the fact of last week, John Cena walking out here on Raw means what Vince has said is true. Anybody can go anywhere. This whole thing is wide open. This can affect anybody from top to bottom. If Cena can come here, anybody can come here. You and I need to make a stand on this thing. Right here tonight, we need to nip this thing in the bud. You and I need to walk out there, and whoever's thinking about coming over here, we need to send them a message. We need to send them a message loud and clear that the Nature Boy and the Game are calling the shots on Raw.
I like it. I like that.
You're damn right.
Some people seem to think that this draft lottery gives them an excuse to walk out here on my show and do whatever they think they can do whenever they think they want to do it. Oh, I'm here to tell you, that ain't happening. We're making a stand right here tonight. So I don't care who you are, Mr. Draft Pick. Come on down here, Mr. Monday Night, and let the Nature Boy and I show you who calls the shots around here.
Who's it gonna be? Who is it?
I don't know. I don't know if I'd want to walk out here right now if I were him.
If it is a him.
This is great.
Well, 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 Triple H. It's been a long time. You know, I can really respect what you've done here on Raw. And you're right. If there was anyone else coming from SmackDown, you're right. They should take the back seat to you. But I'm not just anybody. And your days of being number one here are over. Because Kurt Angle is back on Raw, baby. Woo!
He just did a woo.
He did.
Nobody says woo around here except me. Hey, that's gimmick infringement and you know it.
We'll just saw our first woo off.
Now listen, calm down. Hold on. Let me be the first guy to congratulate you, Kurt. Seriously. Congratulations. It's about time you finally made it back to the big leagues. But you know, Kurt, that doesn't change a thing. This is still my show. I'm about to become the World Heavyweight Champion once again, and that means I call the shots. You call the shots, huh? You know, the last time I saw you, it was WrestleMania 21. You remember? That's the night I made Shawn Michaels tap out. And that's the night you lost your World Heavyweight title and got your ass kicked by Batista. Woo!
That man tonight, inside Hell in a Cell for the World Heavyweight title. But now a wild card has come to Raw by the name of Kurt Angle.
This is getting most interesting here.
Batista obviously had something he wants to say to both of these guys.
How you doing, Kurt? Dave Batista, world champion. Welcome to Raw.
Choke, huh? Choke. I'll tell you what, Curtin. After last night on the ECW pay-per-view, I wouldn't talk about choking if I was you. So if I'm hearing you right, the night after Vengeance, Monday Night Raw, you want a match with me. Is that what I'm hearing?
Yeah, why? What, are you intimidated? What, are you scared of me? You don't want to have a match with me?
Hold on. You think he's intimidated of you?
Obviously.
You think he's scared of you? Hey, listen, I taught him. I trained him. I taught him everything he knows. He's not scared of you. Hell, he doesn't care when he fights you. He's so not scared of you. Why wait until after Vengeance? Why not have the match next week right here on Raw?
That's fine with me. That's
you want to have it? Fine.
Hey, it's a done deal.
Hey. I see what you're doing. Don't do that. The bottom line is, I'm not afraid of either of you. You want your match? Next week, you got it. After I'm done with him, I'll see you in the cell.
Well, it looks like we all got what we want. You got your match, I got my match. I made him a promise, and I'm out here to deliver. What do you say? Kurt Angle, HBK, the rematch at Vengeance.
Oh, hell yeah! You gotta say yes!
Well, you don't have to.
Wait a minute. Let me hear this right. You want to lose to me two times in a row? Well, you're on. You know what? You got a little surprise for me? Well, I got a little surprise for you.
Oh, look out here! And Michaels beating Angle with a punch!
Hey, wait a minute!
Angle back knocking down the gate! And now Triple H hammering Shawn Michaels! And Batista taking down the world's champion!
He had an eight!
And down goes Flair! And Triple H and Shawn Michaels beat the hell out of each other there!
Somebody needs to get out of here! Look out! Oh my God!
Michaels taking down Triple H, Batista, and Angle exchanging right hands. Flair's been incapacitated. All hell has broken loose. All hell has broken loose in Binghamton. It's Batista. War. Get nailed. And now slam by Batista. The count, the cover, and the interruption by Angle. The ref's got to get Angle out of the damn ring. And now Michaels is back in.
Well, Michaels may do it for the ref. He did. He just got Angle out on his head.
Angle and Michaels both on the outside. They may fight all the way to Las Vegas.
Watch it now. Look out.
Over went right out to the concrete floor. Both Michaels and Angle go.
Look out, folks. What is Shawn Michaels doing here?
But let's not forget it's Triple H and Batista, the legal man in this tag team match.
Look at Batista now. He's on the offense. Oh, no.
Face buster by the Game.
You know what that means?
Triple H for the face buster.
Oh,
Batista.
No.
The double A spine buster. I know what it means. My God, what a spine buster. It rattled my Oklahoma hat.
Oh, no. Nate.
Thumbs up. Thumbs down.
Look at Nate.
Oh, Nature Boy. We'll see you in Charlotte.
Oh,
hey. Triple H.
Look at
Ladies and gentlemen, the World Heavyweight Champion, Batista. Last night, Hell in a Cell. It was your first ever Hell in a Cell match, and yet you managed to beat Triple H. You were the underdog. It was a brutal encounter. How are you feeling now, the day after?
Well, I've got holes in my back. I've got holes in my head. And just about every inch of my body is killing me. Honestly, I feel like I was in a war. Triple H and I, we went to war. I don't know how else to put it. And I have to be honest, Todd. Triple H took something from me last night. That cell took something from me that I don't think I'll ever get back.
Was it worth it?
You bet your ass it was worth it, and I'd do it all over again. Look it up. I am the World Heavyweight Champion, and it does not get any bigger than that.